Hey everybody, it's Billy from Spicy Ginger Soap. I am going to go ahead and take the plunge and try to make some foundation, some mineral foundation. I've got, this is my color. It's what I wear from Bare Minerals. It's called Fairly Light. And they tell you to put the color that you use now on this paper here, which is what I'm gonna do. Put a good amount on there, and then it says to wet it with water. That makes it, it makes it darker basically. All right, so there we've got my color. And that's our starting point. So, when I bought all my stuff from TKB, I didn't get the, I know that there's like a recipe file or a recipe book. I didn't get that. So I'm just kind of going off of like the research that I've done and just like winging it basically. So I'm not exactly sure how well this is going to go, but I'm just ready to kind of like make the plunge. So, I've read a lot of different things. I've read ratios, two parts titanium dioxide, one part zinc oxide, one part a base powder, whether it's talc, tapioca starch, corn starch, whatever. And then 3/4 parts mica. And then you come in with your base color at a different time. That's just like your base white powder. And then I found other recipes for, if you want more coverage or if it's for 55 and older, there's like so many different things that you can think of. Well, basically I've got a couple different, so I've got titanium dioxide, the zinc oxide, the high micron, which that is to give better coverage. Like I told you guys before, I'm redhead, I have freckles, I like a little bit more medium full coverage. Then I've got the rose and the rhapsody talc, which I won't use both of them together, I would use one or the other. It's like a base. I've got tapioca starch, you could use that, or cornstarch. And then I also have kaolin clay, but I have really dry skin, so I'm not gonna put the kaolin clay in. For my daughters, I'm definitely gonna use the kaolin clay. Then I've got boron nitride. This is used for adhesion and slip, and it's supposed to help with not settling into fine lines and wrinkles. The magnesium myristrate treated mica. Now this is like when you see sericite mica, this would be one, and it's treated with that magnesium myristate, which is supposed to help with adhesion, slip, mainly adhesion though, and it's supposed to feel really nice. The bismuth oxychloride, this is the pearly sheen. This is used for the regular Bare Minerals foundation, not the matte formula. So if you want a matte formula, you have oily skin, you don't want any dewy, shimmery look at all, you wouldn't use this. And some people don't use this, they don't like this product. I don't have any issues with it. Pash mica, this is a silica treated mica, which when you look at Bare Minerals, some of their products, like especially their finishing, their mineral veil, silica is one of the first ingredients. So this is a silica treated mica. It helps with I wrote everything down. I'm kind of going off of memory, but I don't want to tell you guys anything wrong, so let me look at what... gives a soft, cushiony powder and imparts a soft focus and a dewy finish. So it gives a really nice look and feel. So basically what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and get to it. I am going to do my base powder, so my white base powder basically. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do one teaspoon. I'm going to go ahead and use the Rhapsody talc this time. I'm not sure if there's a big difference. It didn't seem like there really was. Now, see, I don't want to make a huge... I'm going to go ahead and do like quarter teaspoons instead of that full teaspoon, because I can see that this is going to be like... Once I put everything in there, it's going to be a lot. Okay, so, and actually I should tap a little out of there. All right, so a quarter teaspoon of the Rhapsody talc. I'm going to do a quarter teaspoon of my tapioca starch. I'm going to do a half a teaspoon, so 2 quarter teaspoons of the bismuth oxychloride. And then, let's see. Uh-oh, look at that. So that's that that Rhapsody talc. I'm going to go, so basically we probably put more like a half a teaspoon in there, which is fine. That's a base powder. Okay, and then we're going to do... Let me write this down real quick. Half a teaspoon of Rhapsody talc. 1/4 teaspoon tapioca. Half a teaspoon of the bismuth oxychloride. And then we're going to go in with my zinc oxide and my titanium dioxide. And what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to do one thing that it does seem to be pretty universal is 2 parts titanium dioxide to 1 part zinc. So I'm going to do... half a teaspoon of my titanium dioxide and 1/4 teaspoon. What the heck? Of my zinc oxide. Alright, now I'm going to start using my little, let's see how much that, yeah. All right, now I'm going to do the little mini scoops. And I'm gonna do I'm going to use the pinch, which is probably an eighth of a teaspoon, I would say. I'm going to do that for the magnesium myristate mica, the pash mica, and then I'm going to do one down from that, the smidgen of the boron nitride. Pinch of pash mica and MM treated mica, and then smidgen, smidgen of the boron nitride. All right. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to mix that up, and then putting on my little face mask here. And then what I'm going to do with this is I'm just going to check what it feels like. Okay, so it's really white. Feels nice. Looks good to me. I am going to stir it up a bit. Only because the last time that I did a powder in here, I did notice that it did have a little bit of, like, seemed like that bottom layer, some of it gets stuck in the bottom. And I want to make sure everything's really well incorporated. And I'm sorry if that's annoying that to tap that, but I've got to, I don't want it lose a bunch of product in that lid. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and let that be my base powder. And I'm just going to put it in here for now. Then, so that's about, that's probably enough to fill up two of the containers. Now what I'm going to do is we're going to do our color base. This, I'm like kind of scared about. I'm just going to go for it though. So I'll go ahead and, there's a little bit of powder on there. This powder gets like everywhere, you guys, everywhere. Very, very, very small particles. Very powdery, and it just goes all over the place. So be careful. Make sure you wear a mask. You don't want to be sniffing this stuff. Okay, so now I've got my Oriental Beige Mica, my Yellow Oxide, and then I've got my Brown Oxide Ultramarine Blue Chromium Green. I've got this red, the Brick Red, and then I've got the Red 7. They're both red oxides. And I guess I could use the little one first of the Oriental Beige. It's weird. You know, yeah, they forgot my yellow. Yep, they forgot my yellow oxide. I thought I had misplaced it before, but now I've gone through this many times, and yeah, they didn't give me my small one of the yellow oxide. All right, anyways, good thing I ordered these big ones, right? Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to go ahead and mix up the base color, which will be mostly Oriental Beige and yellow. I'm going to again use my 1/4 teaspoon. I'm going to go ahead and do 1/2 teaspoon of the Oriental Beige. And like I said, I'm literally winging this. I don't know if I'm doing this the right way or not. And then I'm going to do same amount, 1/2 teaspoon of the yellow oxide. I'll write this down real quick. Teaspoon Oriental Beige. Half teaspoon yellow oxide. And now, I think I could even get away with not even using like the brown, the blue, and the green. But, I'm going to use, I'm going to do like the smallest amount of the red. And I wonder, because I saw different things saying to use the Brick Red as opposed to this one. So I'm not really sure. I'll go ahead and use this one this time and just see. I have a feeling this goes a very long way. All right. So, one drop. Red oxide, and I put red brick oxide just to specify which one I used, and then I'm going to do the same thing, this drop of the chromium green. I don't even think that was a full scoop, but of the blue. And then I'm gonna do two of the brown. And let's see how that goes. Wow, like it's all over already. That's so crazy. I literally haven't even like hardly done anything yet and it's all over already. Look at that. Oh my gosh. Well, I should have put a, oh my goodness. That's nuts. I should have put something down. So, learn from my mistake. Put down. Oh my gosh, this is literally like staining my countertop. I'm gonna have to use the magic eraser on this thing. Holy moly. I was being so careful too, like not to get anything all over the place. So be careful. Oh, what the heck? I don't even know where it's coming from. It's like coming from everywhere. I think there's some on my gloves. Okay, I'm going to change to clean gloves. Wow, guys, it's crazy. So crazy. Thank goodness for magic erasers, right? These things are like lifesavers. I don't know how they work and I don't even care. Just love that they do. Okay. I'm gonna lay down a paper towel. Put all these on. So they don't get on anything else. Okay. Sorry about that. Brown from what I can see in here. We'll see what it looks like. I'm gonna rinse off my wipe off my little scoopers. Look how dark that is. Very dark. So, but who knows? You know, it's going to go in with that white powder, which is very white. So, that may be the perfect maybe the perfect color. I don't know. And I suppose if you add enough white to it, it'll become the perfect color. So let's go ahead and do it. I'm going to put this in here. Fully incorporated in a couple areas. Oh yeah, it has. Okay, I just want to make sure. Okay. So as you can see, very, very dark brown color. And I'm just going to leave, there's like a little bit of remnants in there. I'm going to show you what this looks like. Very brown. Almost looks like coffee, cocoa powder. That's what it looks like. Okay. So I'm going to put three parts of my white powder. These are heaping also. I'm doing heaping quarter teaspoons. And then I'm going to do I don't want to do a full one. I'm going to do that's a little less than a quarter teaspoon. And see what that looks like. So it's on my pad here too. Okay. How it compares to that one. I'd say it's pretty darn close. Wow. All right, so let's see. I'm going to show you guys like a scoop of it. That's what it looks like. I can already tell by the way this feels on the paper that it's like smoother and softer. So look, that's what it looks like. And it has a really, really nice feel to it. And I actually think that might be, it's pretty close. It's pretty, pretty close. If not a match. So let's see. I'm wetting it now. Look at that, guys. What the heck? So, what I see is that this particular powder that I just made is a little bit more, it's got a little bit maybe more yellow to it, I would say, than my color. My color's probably got like a little bit more either red or blue to it. I'm gonna show you guys that up close. So yeah, I would say my Fairly Light has a little bit more of a like pinky tone to it. So I think maybe like a little bit more red. I'm so scared to even do that. But, all right, let's just do it. I'm afraid to open this darn thing. This time I'm gonna use the regular red. And I'm literally gonna do like, not even a full drop, since this isn't even that base color. I'm just gonna do like a teeny tiny bit. Look at that, it's already on my finger. This stuff is a nightmare, holy moly. Careful. This stuff's like, it'll ruin something for sure. Okay. And I think what I'm going to do too, because it looks also a little bit light, I think I'm going to add a bit more of, like, this is one more drop. I'm going to add one more drop of my color. Because it does seem a tad light. All right. Oh boy, it's too pink now. Wow, way too pink. So see, that stuff just goes such a long way. Okay. See how pink it is now? Okay, so let's see. I think what I'll do is I'll add some more of my, I'm going to add another quart, wait, that's a whole teaspoon. Well, I'm going to go ahead, I'm going to add a teaspoon. And a quarter teaspoon of this one. Yeah. still really pink. Really, really pink. So what I'll do is, it's like red. So I just need to add some yellow. I'm gonna add a smidgen, a heaping smidgen of yellow. I would say, even though this is too pink, it's better than this one. This one was too light. So we'll get there. You know, was I really thinking I was gonna get there like the very first try? That's like kind of impossible, right? So. All right, it's still way, way too red. So, one quarter. I'm gonna just use everything I've got left in here. It's basically a quarter and an eighth. Of a teaspoon of the white. So adding that red, it was way too much. I should have literally used like a quarter of that little drop. The drop scooper. Hasn't really even changed. So I'm gonna add I don't know if I should add a full quarter. Alright, let's do a pinch of the yellow. Now, hold on, let me make sure, let's see, if it's too pink, yeah, add yellow. So that's the right thing to do. Add a pinch. So if I had it to do over again, what I would do is I would actually just add that red, that little pinch of red, to this base color. And it's silly because I thought about that, but I didn't want to transfer everything around, but I should have. Because I think that might have been what would have made it, you know, would have been the right thing to do. And to be honest, as I'm looking at this dry, the tone is pretty good. I don't know that it needs a whole lot more pink. I think it just needed more of the base color. This just keeps looking very, very pink to me. Okay, so that's where we're at right now. It is getting closer to what we need. But still on the pink side. And it's getting darker. So this is what I'm going to do. I'm going to get this out of here. Okay. I'm gonna make a new white base, same way I made it the first time. And then I'm going to try just adding a little bit more of this and see if that does the trick. So we'll see. Let's go for it. All right. And obviously there's a little bit in here, but it's okay. All right. Half a teaspoon of the bismuth. Smidgen of the boron nitride. Pinch of the pashmica. Pinch of the magnesium myristate mica. This wasn't closed all the way. No wonder I had a little bit of like powder kind of around that I didn't know where it came from. Okay, and then we've got our Rhapsody talc, half a teaspoon. And then the zinc oxide, we've got 1/4 teaspoon. And our titanium dioxide, 1/2 teaspoon. Stuff's kind of like hard to get. clumps up. Okay. All right, did I remember everything? Oh, tapioca starch. 1/4 teaspoon. Okay, so now we're gonna do get this all nice and make sure everything in the bottom. And this time, I'm just going to leave this in here and I'm going to go ahead and do the whole batch. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do 1/4 teaspoon of this color concentrate. Plus 1/4 teaspoon and a pinch. Actually, no, since it's more a dash. 1/4 teaspoon plus a dash of the color concentrate. I think I might put just a little bit of that red this in there, because this still looks a little bit more red than this does. So let's see, I'm gonna start a new paper. I did my white base plus 1/4 teaspoon and a smidgen. No, it was a dash. Sorry, guys. Plus a dash of color concentrate. And then I'm going to add a pinch of this one. Thank you. that looks like a pretty good match to me. So there's what we've got right now. And I would say it's just a tad lighter than my original. So I'm gonna add a pinch. Gosh. I want to be really careful. I'm going to add a smidgen of this one. Because I just don't want to go too far. Doesn't seem like a lot, but I'd rather put too little than too much. Well, I'll be darned. I think I'm about there. So that's where we're at right now. I would say that's pretty darn close. Definitely still slightly yellow, but I'll have to use it on my face. But I think we got one really close. Yeah. Very, very close. So look at them side by side, guys. This is my Bare Minerals, and this is the one that I just made. I think that's pretty good. I would say that's a pretty darn close match. If anything, I do still think the one I just made is slightly lighter than my Bare Minerals. Yeah, it's slightly lighter, slightly more yellow. So what I'll do is I'm tempted to put one more. That's what I'm going to do. And put one more smidgen of this red foundation in here. I know this is like slow going. Unfortunately, that's just kind of the nature of this. So, you know, you have to be patient if you're going to make your own makeup. That didn't change anything. One more smidgen. You have to remember too that this has the white base in it, so it's not as concentrated color wise. A little bit better. I'm going to do another smidgen. Okay, two smidgens, red foundation, one smidge of color concentrate. Hope we've got it. Just killing me. It's still too yellow. There's my bare minerals. There's me. What I've got in there right now. It is a little darker, so I think the tone is good, but it just needs a tiny bit of red. It's like I can't get that red right. All right, one more smidgen. All right. I'm going to call that pretty good match. There's my original and there's what I've got right now. Now I'm going to go ahead and stop at that. I will say slightly more yellow. But it's a pretty good match. Once I use it on my face, I'll know for sure, you know, what I think of it. So that was a long process, right? Took quite a while to get to the end result. But now that I've got the formula, it should be, and plus I've got like a ton of product here, it should be much easier the next time. And I kind of know now not to use too much of that red. Don't ever put it into my base powder. Only ever put it into the color concentrate. Oops. So, I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it wasn't too long and boring. But if you ask me, I got a pretty good match. I'm really actually kind of surprised. I was kind of thinking it was going to be a lot harder than that. And even though it took a while, like, I just took a wrong turn with that red is all. If I wouldn't have done that, I think it wouldn't have been near as time consuming if I would have just put that red concentrate into the color concentrate. I think I would have been much better off. So there we go. That's the end result. I'm really happy with it. And I hope you guys enjoyed. I hope it maybe inspires you guys to do some experimenting. And I will bring you guys back. The next time I'll probably be doing blusher, bronzer, and eyeshadows. So subscribe, like, and comment. I'll see you guys soon.